Tanguk John.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Foldable session. My name is Sanguk Chun. I'm the head of Core Platform Lab, which is an engineering team mainly working on One UI-based Android framework and the watch-based studio. I'm very excited to meet all of you here today and have a chance to introduce Samsung's enhanced foldable user experiences, including multitasking. So let's get started. Here's the contents. First, I will talk about the foldable market first, and then explain Samsung's key experiences of foldable devices one by one. Let's talk about the foldable market first. As you already know, the foldable market is growing rapidly with massive effort and investment from various manufacturers. And it is expected that the shipment will hit over 27 million units by 2025. Along with the growth of the foldable market, Samsung's foldable shipment has grown 4 times last year compared to 2020. By shipping over 10 million units, Samsung occupies 88% of foldable market share. In 2019, Samsung launched the first generation of Galaxy Fold. After that, 6 more foldable models were launched by this year. From the beginning, we have been trying to enhance foldable user experiences with Galaxy G Fold and G Flip as well. Especially for Galaxy G Fold, we have focused on the large screen experiences and enhanced productivity, including multitasking. And we continue to enhance customization experiences for self-expression and uniqueness with Galaxy G Flip. In the process of enhancing foldable user experiences, we learned that the best user experiences comes from the synergy between apps and the capabilities of the device. Through the collaboration with the partners, we are able to provide optimized foldable user experiences with these apps. We really appreciate your effort, and we look forward to collaborating with more partners and developers for the enhancement. To help developers understand more about Samsung foldables, I'd like to introduce 3 key experiences: multitasking, flex mode, and large screen optimizations. So let's take a look at each item. I will start a feature for Galaxy G Fold first. For years, we have been trying to enhance the productivity with the large screen. And we believe the multitasking has the key role for the productivity. So for the multitasking, we provide taskbar and multi-window features to help users easily launch multiple apps. Let's talk about the taskbar first. I can say that the taskbar is one of the most notable features in Galaxy G Fold 4 based on 12L. We have been thinking about how to help users quickly launch apps on a large screen. That is why we have introduced the concept of pinned edge in Galaxy G Fold 3 last year. Along with that, we are having lots of discussions with Google for more intuitive and easier way of utilizing multiple apps. As a result, based on the new platform, 12L, we provide a taskbar feature in Galaxy G Fold 4. The taskbar appears at the bottom of the screen while using an app. It shows the favorite apps on the home screen and recently used apps. And users can launch any app with the OS buttons in the left side of the taskbar. Personally, I love this feature because I can access any app, whatever I want, without returning to the home screen. And that really helps my productivity. The Taskbar also helps users launch multiple apps at the same time. While using an app, users can launch another app by dragging up the app icon from the taskbar and drop it wherever they want. With this simple action, users can easily switch to split-screen view or run the app as a pop-up view. Here are some tips to optimize your apps with Taskbar. The Taskbar is a new system bar different from the existing navigation bar. In case of screen with navigation button, the height of the Taskbar is the same with that of the navigation bar. So in this case, there needs no actions to take in app's perspective as long as the app considers the height of the navigation bar. But when it comes to the gesture navigation, the height of the taskbar will not be the same with that of the navigation bar. So in case that your app directly refers the framework resource for the navigation bar height, it might be overlapped with the taskbar. So we recommend you refer the system bar inset from Windows Inset Compat API instead of using the framework resource for the navigation bar height. You may also need to consider the dynamic changes in the system bar inset. In gesture navigation, the taskbar can be shown and hidden dynamically by long pressing the taskbar area. If your app uses the inset value to draw its UI, you need to consider the case that the value is changed while your app is in the foreground. For this, we recommend you handle changes of the inset value with View Compat API. Another feature for the multitasking is the multi-window. Even before the foldables, we have provided this feature for years. Now it has become super important for foldables because it can maximize the advantages of foldables. Along with the taskbar, we start providing another ways to access multi-window. One of them is the window handle. Previously, the window handle was shown only when the app is in multi-window. Now, the handle can appear even in single window. Pressing the handle shows three buttons. With these buttons, users can switch to split screen view or pop-up view or close the app. Another way of starting multi-window is using gesture. Users can quickly switch to split screen view by swiping the app screen from the leftmost side or rightmost side with two fingers. I also use this gesture a lot to start multi-window, and I can say that this is a really great feature. It is not enough to complete the multitasking experiences just with the platform features I have explained. The key to the completion comes from the app support for the multi-window. So we would like to ask you, app developers, to consider the behavior of your apps in multi-window. Your apps may be able to run in multi-window by default unless you explicitly declare your apps as non-resizable. But there are several things to consider more. The first one is to support various window sizes. Supporting multi-window means that your app will be shown in various window sizes. So you need to check whether your app is flexible enough to properly draw its layout in various window configurations. Secondly, we would like to ask you to consider multi-region environment. The platform supports multiple apps in region state at the same time when they are running in multi-window, but the focus can be set only to a single app. So please check whether your app works properly in region state with no focus. Lastly, if you want your app to launch another app or instance in split screen view, you can consider to use the flag named flag activity launch adjacent. Drag and drop between apps is one of the useful experiences in multi-window. By moving or copying contents like text, images, and objects from one window to another, we can improve users' productivity. For this to be done, we need apps capabilities to enable dragging contents and handle the transferred contents. So if you think your app can contribute to the productivity when contents are sent to other apps or received from other apps, please consider the implementation of drag and drop capabilities by taking a look at the guideline. Another capabilities of apps that we would like to ask you to consider is multi-instance. There are some cases that improve productivity when multiple instances of a single app are shown simultaneously in multi-window. Examples include the two instances of the same browser app or those of the same Office app. So again, if you think your app can contribute to the productivity with multi-instances, please declare your app support multi-instance, declare your app support multi-instance by following the guideline. The second key experiences of Samsung Foldable is the flex mode. This is a feature common to Galaxy G Fold and G Flip, indicating that the device is partially folded. By putting the partially folded device to somewhere flat, users can use the device without holding it. In addition, users can use the bottom half of the screen to control or navigate the device. Thanks to the active support from partners, we are able to provide better hands-free experiences with flex mode in video call and meeting. I also use these apps a lot with my G Fold 4, and I'm pretty sure that using these apps without holding the device is a great experience. While in flex mode, users can use the bottom half of the screen to control the device. For example, users can take photos or videos using the buttons in the bottom half of the screen. As a device feature, Galaxy G Fold and G Flip provides a simple control panel when the device goes into the flex mode to help apps that do not support flex mode yet. With the control panel, users can navigate the device or change the volume and brightness. Although we provide generic control panel for apps, we believe that the user experiences for flex mode will be maximized when apps are fully optimized for the flex mode. And we are excited that the flex mode experiences is keep expanding across more partner apps. But still, we are awaiting more apps fully support the flex mode. You can support flex mode by making your app fold aware. To do that, we recommend to use the JPEG Window Manager library, which provides APIs for foldable devices. Through the library, Galaxy G Fold and G Flip will notify apps whether the device is in half-open state or flat state. So for the flex mode, please consider designing proper M layout when the device is in half-open state. Samsung and Google have been working closely together to improve the JPEG Window Manager library over 3 years. As a result, the stable version 1.0.0 has been finally released January this year. And I'm pretty sure that both of us will keep collaborating to improve the library so that we can expand foldable user experiences in the Android ecosystem. The last key experiences is the large screen optimization with One UI 4.1.1 on 12L. The Galaxy G Fold has the capabilities of providing tablet-like large screen experiences with the portability of a phone. So Samsung and Google together have been trying to deliver optimize the large screen experiences on Galaxy G Fold. Now we provide apps optimized for large screen and support a feature for the large screen called Activity Embedding. Especially this year, Google has updated their apps, including Gmail, Messages by Google, and Meet, optimized for large screen. And more Google apps are being updated to improve large screen experiences. Not only Google apps, but also popular apps like Facebook, Microsoft Office, and TikTok are contributing to the improvement of large screen experiences. We really appreciate your effort, and we look forward to more apps design their layouts optimized for the large screen. To help apps take advantage of large screen, Galaxy G Fold, based on 12L, supports a feature named Activity Embedding, which enables apps show activities side by side, as shown in the slide. Prior to 12L, to show more information on a large screen, you had to convert your app activities to multi-pane layout using Fragment. And that required significant refactorings for app developers, which is why some apps are not optimized for large screen yet. But the activity embedding requires a little effort to split apps task window. Based on simple XML configurations or JPEG window manager API calls from apps, the platform will automatically show your activities side by side or stacked. Let me show you an example how it will look like to configure an XML for the activity embedding. Let's say that the activity B appears by the call from the activity A. And if you want the activity B to be appear at the right side of the activity A on large screen, you can just define the relationships between the two in the XML, as shown in the slide. Just with this simple declaration, the two activities will be shown in stacked state on folded Galaxy G Fold and side by side on unfolded Galaxy G Fold. Now, I believe this is pretty much simpler than using multi-pane layout with Fragment. So please take a look at activity embedding with JPEG window manager library and make your app optimized for the large screen. Finally, I want to emphasize again that the key to improve foldable user experiences is the synergy between the capabilities of the device and apps. For the capabilities of the device, Google and Samsung will keep collaborating to provide the best platform for the foldable devices. And we look forward to app developers provide optimized foldable user experiences by fully utilizing the platform. So this is the end of my talk. Thank you for listening.